Warning, this experiment handles boiling and corrosive hydrobromic acid. This should be performed with gloves outside or in fume hood. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make hydrobromic acid. In a previous video, I used it to make sulfuric acid from sulfur and water. But since hydrobromic acid is not easily obtained in and of itself, we'll need to make it from domestically available chemicals. We start with 300 milliliters of a 35% solution of sodium bromide. It's available as a chemical for swimming pools. The reason why I'm using this particular percentage is because all of my local stores sell it pre-mixed as a 35% solution. If you have solid sodium bromide, then just mix 140 grams of it with 260 milliliters of water to match the solution I'm using here. Anyway, once you have your solution of sodium bromide, add a stir bar, and then add 200 grams of sodium bisulfate. This is sold as a pH lowering chemical also for swimming pools. Now stir and heat the mixture until everything dissolves. There might be a tiny bit of lingering cloudiness, but as long as all of the granules of sodium bisulfate are dissolved, this is fine. Now turn off the heating and let the mixture cool to room temperature. What we're doing here is reacting the sodium bromide with sodium bisulfate to produce hydrobromic acid and sodium sulfate. Most lab manuals and chemistry resources on the internet specify the use of sulfuric acid rather than sodium bisulfate. You can do this if you want, but I'm going to assume that sodium bisulfate is much more readily available to you. Anyway, as the mixture cools, the sodium sulfate will crystallize out. Now to remove even more sodium sulfate and drive the reaction forward, we'll place the beaker in an ice bath. Sodium sulfate has dramatically reduced solubility near freezing temperatures. After an hour or so, remove the beaker and filter off the sodium sulfate crystals. You can see here the massive amount of sodium sulfate still in the beaker. Let me skip ahead to when the filtration is finished. So here is our solution of hydrobromic acid. There's still a lot of sodium sulfate still dissolved, so to further purify it, we're going to distill it. Set up a distillation apparatus as shown here and turn on the cooling, the stirring, and the heating, and distill off the hydrobromic acid. The reason why we went through the trouble of cooling and filtering the sodium sulfate crystals first, instead of just distilling it directly, is because there's so much sodium sulfate that when it starts precipitating during the distillation, it will actually insulate the solution above it and greatly slow down distillation, sometimes even stopping it. So we removed as much of it as we could beforehand with chilling and filtration to make our later distillation smoother and more manageable. Anyway, just distill all the way to dryness. So this is our solution of distilled hydrobromic acid. To test your acid, get a small sample and then stick in two carbon electrodes. Pass a voltage of about 3 volts through them. At the negative terminal, tiny little bubbles of hydrogen gas will form. At the positive terminal, the bromide ions are being oxidized to bromine that react with other bromide ions to form tribromide, and this gives a yellowish liquid of tribromide that flows off the electrode. And that's how you make hydrobromic acid. Thanks for watching! If you would like to contribute to the continued production of science videos like this one, please support the channel on Patreon. Links are in the video description. In this video, we're going to make sulfuric acid from sulfur and water using a new process I found that I'm calling the electrobromine process.